In the ongoing conflict between Israel and Palestine, both sides are firing rockets and missiles. While there are airstrike military offensive by Israel, it is Hamas from Palestine that has been firing rockets. As of now, 48 Palestinians, including 14 children and 3 women, have died, while 300 others have been wounded. The Israeli offensive in Gaza Strip toppled a massive building, and 10 senior military figures of Hamas have been killed in airstrikes. Hamas has claimed that it has launched 130 rockets at Israel. You may see the firebirds glares in the Israeli skies. Most of these rockets have been neutralized in the sky only. Israel not only have been successful in protecting lands, buildings, strategic assets, but also by and large saved lives. And the credit for neutralizing Hamas rockets in the sky goes to Israeli Iron Dome, the air defense which Israel operationalized in April 2011 with the first interception. In this video, I'll tell you about the Iron Dome and does India has any such system. So let's get started. Short and medium range rocket and artillery attacks are a lethal minas. They endanger the lives of hundreds of thousands of civilians and inflict heavy damage to the property. They are becoming a strategic threat also. The genesis of Iron Dome goes back to 2006 Israeli-Lebanon war, when the Hezbollah fired thousands of rockets into Israel. The following year, Israel announced that its state-run Rafale advanced systems would come up with a new air defense system to protect its cities and people. To thwart this unprecedented threat, Israel's Rafale advanced defense systems has developed a first-of-its-kind counter-rocket artillery mortar CRAM system, Iron Dome, with pinpointed accuracy interceptor against asymmetric threats. The system includes a battle management and control unit, BMC, detection and tracking radar, and launchers, each equipped with 20 lethal interceptor, the Tamir missile. The system is mobile, deployed in rapid, and maintenance is simple and user-friendly. A single launcher protects the area of a medium-sized city or strategic installation. The system can protect stationary or mobile forces against short and medium-range threats. The radar detects and tracks the threat. The data is transferred to the BMC and to the launcher, and from launcher to the interceptor. The interceptor seeker achieves very accurate and game homing. Fully linked to other command and control systems in the arena, Iron Dome exchanges data with sensors to maximize its combat efficiency and avoid fratricide. The system estimates the track threats, point of impact, and selects to intercept only those which falls in the protected area. This prevents unnecessary launches against non-threatening targets and make Iron Dome a very cost-effective system. The innovative system has proven its capability to detect and home in on small targets flying at very high speed and over a large area, even in severe weather conditions. Iron Dome operates automatically day and night. The system intercepts threats, destroys them in the protected area, outside the protected area. Interceptor war is precisely timed to ensure destruction of incoming warhead. Sometimes it is almost impossible to hit the target directly each time, which is why there is something in each missile called proximity fuse, which is a laser-guided controlled fuse. When passing within few meters of the target, generally 10 meters, this activates and blasts the missile with shrapnel that destroys the target. The first operational interception was in April 2011, and till then it has intercepted around 3,000 targets in Israel alone. Rafale defense system is continuously upgrading its system by looking at enemies changing strategies, that is of Hamas. The drone and UAV has become an increasing threat, but Iron Dome does not waste interceptor for hard kill of micro drones. Rather, it jams and controls the communication of such micro drones. It has successfully upgraded to intercept UAVs of any kind for hard kill. US is actively seeking to deploy Iron Dome in battlefields like Iraq, in addition to air defense of Patriot missile defense system. It fits into tactical short-range tactical missiles to high range. Iron Dome allows to counter drones to cruise missiles. Rafale is further upgrading to deal with future and complicated threats. It is going to be next sky spotter. Rafale is not only seeking RF sensors, but also electro-optical sensors, which means that they have redundancy and capability to defeat any kind of threat 360 degree around the defended area. The idea is to use electro-optical sensor for detection and sharing the data with all kind of other sensors. Rafael has partnered with Raytheon, with whom they have developed and produced, you may be aware, DBIT Sling system. And from 2019, Raytheon, with more than 30 vendors, is producing Iron Dome interceptors in US itself. The next move is to produce Iron Dome launchers as well as in US through a joint venture. Rafael has given batteries of Iron Dome to US, who has integrated Iron Dome into its defense layers. Initially, US is using Iron Dome for strategic defense, and that may be followed by homeland security. So now coming to India, India also thought of procuring Iron Dome, but Israel is a smaller territory while India is a vast country, so it has gone for the long-range Russian S-400 missile defense system. A few years back, if you remember, former DRDO chief Dr. V.K. Saraswat has confirmed that India's own missile defense shield is mature and ready for quick deployment to intercept ballistic missiles of 2000 km range. Dr. Saraswat has said that system was to be upgraded to 5000 km by 2016. But then you see India buying Russian missile defense system S-400 in ₹50,000 crores. Now you may be wondering that how about hitting a just $1,000 rocket with $80,000 Tamir interceptor missile be justified? Well, if in a nation where every life is precious, then it doesn't matter, especially it proves a successful deterrent to the enemy of a nation. Hope you like this video. If yes, do give it a thumbs up, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching National Defense. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.